Let's go now to Europe Bureau Chief Hugh Whitfeld at Buckingham Palace. Hugh, you have new details about King Charles and his diagnosis. What's been revealed?
Yeah, and coming up to lunchtime here in London, day two of the King's treatment for cancer. Keep in mind that it's so rare for us to get a health update on any of the royals, let alone details about a cancer diagnosis. So while that's rare, it is also a difficult situation because we don't know exactly what type of cancer the King does have. We are now being told, though, that the cancer seems to have been caught in the early stages, a revelation made by the British Prime Minister Rishi Sunak in a morning radio interview here in Britain.
Like everyone else, you're shocked and sad, and just all our thoughts are with him and his family. And, you know, thankfully, this has been caught early, and now everyone will be wishing him that he gets the treatment that he needs and makes a full recovery.
So even though the King is stepping away from public duties, so that's the sort of visits to hospitals and churches and schools across the UK and indeed around the world, he is going to be continuing private work behind the scenes, the business of being the monarch, and that will include obviously meeting with the British Prime Minister on a weekly basis, if not in person, then via Zoom or those audiences occurring over the phone, Ange.
Indeed. Now, Hugh, we're expecting a family reunion in the coming hours. What do you know?
Yeah, well, we know that the King shared the news of his cancer diagnosis with his two sons, William and Harry, on the phone before that news was made public. That gave Harry a bit of a chance to get some affairs in order and allow him to work out how to get home to the UK to see his father. Now, we understand that the Duke of Sussex was seen boarding a plane at LAX. He is on a commercial flight, and the expectation is that he will land at Heathrow in the next couple of hours. Now, we don't know what Harry will do straight away, but it is highly likely that he'll head straight for Clarence House to see his father, the King. It'll be the first time that they've spent an extended period of time together, certainly since the coronation, and certainly before that, since the Queen's funeral. There was no meeting together when Harry attended a charity event last year here. So those strained relations could be potentially repaired, including with his brother, Prince William. But the focus right now, of course, is on the King. And you'd like to think that that's going to be Harry's focus going forward as well.
Indeed. If there's any silver lining, it would be lovely to see that rift resolved. Thanks so much, Hugh Whitfeld.